What's up, everybody? It's your boy Nate. So about a year ago, I made a list of the most useful, most innovative, and just outright dope plugins for After Effects. Anyways, everyone loved it. They made some super dope stuff and ended up saying, Nate, check this out too. And we ended up checking all of it out. And here we are a year later in a new studio, new Nate, new wife, new After Effects. But mainly, we're going to be talking about the best new plugins because let's face it, this year has just been a cluster of awesome plugins. Only the best of the best have made it to this list. So without further ado, I'm super excited. I know you are too. All right, let's go. So if you're new to the channel, you probably are like, why is Nate so excited about After Effects? Well, let me tell you really quickly. It's probably because it is an award-winning software that has been used throughout Hollywood, short films, all sorts of places between the internet, music videos, you name it. And people have been creating just mind-blowing visual effects, motion graphics, character animations, all thanks to the use of After Effects. But anyways, After Effects would not be as amazing if it wasn't thanks to a little secret sauce that is plugins. So you may see a whole bunch of people making really dope stuff, but sometimes they might not say that, hey, they use Element 3D to create all of these awesome 3D visuals, or that they even use something like Motion to create some super smooth animations. Well, you know what today we're gonna be doing? We're gonna be breaking down some of the best plugins for After Effects, going through the most useful, most innovative, and honestly just best bang for buck when it comes to enhancing After Effects' capabilities and speeding up your workflow. So whether you're new to the software or an After Effects vet, I guarantee you're gonna wanna stick around until the end. Okay, so first up on the list at number 10, one of the best glitch art plugins for After Effects, and that is Data Mosh 2. It's a plugin that you can find on AScripts for about $49. And if you guys have paid attention in the past, I've talked about data moshing because it is one of the most super creative techniques that you can do when it comes to glitch art and video. And thanks to Data Mosh 2, After Effects gets a whole new reboot with being able to do data moshing right inside of the software. So Data Mosh 2 comes from one of my favorite plugin developers of all time, aptly named Plug and Play. They always come out with super dope plugins that not only have super smooth UIs, but just work well with After Effects, while also adding an unimaginable functionality. So when I first got into data moshing, I had been inspired from checking out videos like Kanye West, and then I ended up seeing Lamborghini High from ASAP Rocky. And I gotta admit, the process to data moshing was slow, tedious, and I think anyone in the glitch art community would just agree it's something that is a straight up pain in the ass. So when Plug and Play made the data moshing plugin for After Effects, which removed a lot of the headache, it ended up being one of my favorite plugins. I love how they revamped this plugin with moshing engines that allow for greater precision in fine-tuning motion vectors and how pixels move. Being able to use these markers and presets really makes the process so much fun to play with. It's only about $49, which when you think about how much time it can save and the awesome results, I think it is well worth it. It adds so much functionality to After Effects and works really, really well, and for that reason, Data Mosh 2 gets a well-deserved Black Mixture stamp of approval. Next up at number 9. Okay, so this next plugin is a beast at handling rigging and character animation in After Effects. That's right, we're talking about Limber, which is a plugin that you can find for about $40 on AScripts. Now, I don't know why After Effects has gone this long without making their own character rigging tool, but thanks to Limber, we get the ability to add all sorts of custom IK and FK rigs right within the software. Now, I first found out this plugin from Ben Merritt, who recommended it for character animation. When I looked more into it, I realized that pretty much everyone was saying the same thing, from EC Abrams to Motion by Nick, which if you take a look at their work, you can probably agree that character animation and Limber is a super, super powerful plugin. Now, I know it may be a little bit intimidating because if you're just first starting out, there's so many different options with it, but it helps that there are a lot of free tutorials online, especially here on YouTube, if you decide it's for you. So anyways, this plugin is for those who are getting serious about character animation in After Effects, and for that reason, it gets a well-deserved Black Mixture stamp of approval. Next up at number 8, we have Cinemat, which is a chromakeyer plugin. If you guys don't know what chromakeying is, it's pretty much the process of removing a color from a background. Typically, whenever you are looking at a green screen and you need to remove the green in that, the super technical term for that is chromakeying. We have a plugin from 36pix, which comes out the gate. Thanks to this plugin, all we have to do is just apply Cinemat to some sort of green screen footage, and instantly all the settings get calibrated to give us a really dope key. And if we want to fine tune some of the settings, we can, to give us different outputs or even remove the person from the background entirely to create a clean plate. It's just really cool to have Cinemat automatically detect the background, key out the footage, change the spill suppressor, and color correct the footage to match, all while making use of your graphics card and letting you get specific if things just don't go right the first time. I also love the algorithms for keeping hair look super clean, and I also love the algorithm for removing those shadow blobs that may happen whenever you're using a green screen that just has those little shadows on it from different wrinkles and whatnot. Anyways, this plugin saves a lot of time for those who have to do some serious chroma keying and a lot of footage. And for $79, it can save you a whole lot of time on your chroma keying projects. For that reason, Cinemat gets a well-deserved Black Mixture stamp of approval. Number 7 on the list. So this next plugin is my favorite for creating buttery smooth bokeh. That's right, we're talking about Fast Bokeh Pro from the super dope developers Robite. So Fast Bokeh Pro is a super useful plugin that saves you so much time. If you've ever tried rendering out from a 3D software like Cinema 4D or Maya, then you know just how painstakingly difficult it can be. Not only does it take forever, but it is also limiting because all of the depth of field is literally baked into the image. But by using something like depth maps and a plugin like Fast Bokeh Pro, instead you're then able to just select your focus point in post and fine tune the depth of field and bokeh effects with so much more ease. Fast Bokeh Pro is available for $50 at Ascripts, and at that price point, $50 can really save you so much time and give you so much more functionality with your 3D renders. Yeah, this plugin works so well, and I just love how powerful it is. For that reason, Fast Bokeh Pro gets a well-deserved Black Mixture stamp of approval. We're getting down to number 6 on the list. Okay, so next up on the list is one of my favorite plugins for time ramps and time remapping in After Effects. That's right, I'm talking about the super dope plugin from Revision FX, Twixtor, and Twixtor Pro. Now, I will warn you guys, this is not a cheap plugin at all. It is super costly. The regular version costs $329, and then the pro version costs $595. Honestly, guys, that's a lot of money. Now, the power of this plugin is that it does something that After Effects can't do that well, which is generate frames in between motion vectors whenever you're slowing down footage. So let's say I shot something in 60 frames per second and I wanted to slow it down by half. That'll work out pretty fine because then I could just change the frame rate to 30 frames per second and I'll get about half speed. Let's say I wanted to run like it's at like 1% of the speed, in which, you know, you'd have to probably film at like 3,000 frames per second. That's pretty much impossible to do unless you have something like a $50,000 high-speed camera, or have something like Twixtor, which will use their algorithms to generate the images in between. It is super, super powerful, and honestly, I've used it to create stuff without having a crazy rig like the slow-mo guys have. I've seen all sorts of creatives use Twixtor to create all sorts of awesome time remaps for music videos, commercials, you name it, and for that reason, Twixtor gets a well-deserved Black Mixture stamp of approval. Okay, so halfway through the list at number 5, this next plugin has to be probably the coolest one that I've seen come out this year and one of the most useful for character animation. That's right, I'm talking about DK Motion Tool. Now, it's a collaboration between DK Motion on Instagram and Motion Design School. When I first saw this plugin, I thought it looked strangely similar to Limber, except when I actually dived in, I was quickly blown away by the super clean UI and the functionality of it. The ease of making dope animations quickly was just such a mind-blowing experience, because using Limber might be a little bit intimidating, but having these easy markers and control points and character creation tools makes animating in After Effects fun and interesting. I love this plugin for the character animation tools, such as this character animation assistant, which stuck out probably more than these high price point of $75. By the way, you can find this plugin on Ascripts. This is just such a fun and interesting way to animate scenes. I gotta give it to DK Motion and Motion Design School for making such a dope plugin, and for that reason, it gets a well-deserved BLACKMIXTURE stamp of approval. Next up at number 4, this next plugin I've seen in all sorts of movies, video games, music videos, and just about everywhere trying to get that Michael Bay movie-esque lens flare. That's right, we're talking about Video Copilot's Optical Flare plugin for After Effects. Now, Optical Flares is a pricey plugin at $124. It is also super useful because it just works really well and gives you so much. Now, if you don't know what an optical flare is, it's pretty much whenever you're filming a light source and you get the camera and the lens just at the right angle, you're gonna get these really cool shapes and artifacts from the light hitting the sensor. And normally it's pretty difficult to fine tune and replicate a certain look in real life, but thanks to a plugin like Video Copilot's Optical Flares, you can really tweak the exact look and feel of all sorts of lens flares, from having grungy ones to super sci-fi looking ones. It's such a useful technique for creating moods and styles to your footage and really enhancing your composited shot. And for that reason, Video Copilot's Optical Flares gets a well-deserved BLACKMIXTURE stamp of approval. At number 3 on the list, we have Motion V3 from one of my favorite developers, Mount Mograph. The Motion series plugins have been some of the dopest plugins since they came out. Before I can even touch animation in After Effects, I always have to have this plugin installed, because since using it, it is honestly impossible to go back to the traditional method of opening up the keyframe assistant animation window and then going into this graph editor and changing the speed graphs and doing all this thing. Yeah, forget that boring method, because using Motion V3, control these using sliders is so much easier and so much more useful. Yeah, it's just a freaking time saver. Not only that, but Motion V3 comes jam-packed with features that I can go on and on about, but some of my favorite things have to be the project sorter, which will sort all the different elements inside of your project panel so you don't have a super messy project and it looks nice and clean for you to package up. And then also the different expression tools like the Excite, as well as this really intuitive keyframe adjustment editor. Yeah, I could go on and on about how dope this plugin is and how much time it saves, but let me just save the time and let you know that this plugin gets a well-deserved BLACKMIXTURE stamp of approval. The second to last at number 2 on the list, this next plugin came out the gate as a huge surprise, mainly because I never thought it was possible to be able to use Blender 3D information inside of After Effects. What here we have now, Blender AE, which adds in a really dope way to import 3D data into After Effects to create all sorts of composited graphics or even just mess around with 3D. The results look super dope. Now, I will warn that this plugin is like freaking brand new. Do expect like a little bit of roughness around the edges. It's not the cleanest plugin out right now, but at $30, it is pretty fun to mess around with something that's developing and growing in After Effects. For that reason, I gotta applaud the innovation of Blender AE, and it gets a well-deserved BLACKMIXTURE stamp of approval. Yo, last but not least, number 1 on the list. You know a plugin video would not be complete if we did not mention this one. That's right, I'm talking about FX Console. It is a plugin that has been my favorite plugin of all time. It's been my favorite for years, pretty much. Since installing it, it's been used on every single project. I'm honestly surprised that no one even challenged to create another plugin that does kind of the same thing or even a little bit better. But then again, I'm also not surprised, because this plugin already comes from one of the dopest developers of all time, Video Copilot, and the OG Andrew Kramer. By the way, my favorite plugin is a free one, so yeah, go ahead, download it, save yourself some time. It gives you this really cool pop-up window. Love it a lot. It gets a well-deserved BLACKMIXTURE stamp of approval. And yo, you guys, we got an extra one at number 0 on the list. I'm just swearing. But we actually do have an extra one. Anyways, so this next one is not so much of a plugin as much as it is a really useful evolving resource kit for creating all sorts of visuals, graphics, media in general. That's right, I'm talking about Envato Elements. So I've been using Envato Elements for a couple of years now, and since using it, I honestly can say I can't go back because having access to thousands of really dope, high quality assets is such a game changer, especially whenever I'm like, yo, I want to add something really cool like these sparks or these explosions. Being able to just search that up, download it, import it into a project, or let's say even being able to pull up some sort of music to use inside of these videos. Yeah, all of that is possible thanks to Envato Elements. You know, I figured, hey, at the price point of Envato Elements, the time that it saves me and the amount of resources that it gives me is just well worth it. And I like that it has assets and templates for things like After Effects, Premiere Pro, Photoshop, the whole suite, while also having high quality music and video assets, and yeah, just so much, much more. It's honestly my favorite by far on the list, even though it's not a direct plugin for After Effects. For that reason, it gets a well-deserved BLACKMIXTURE stamp of approval. Okay, so hopefully you guys found a plugin that was useful for you that you can take away into making some super dope stuff. And a quick disclaimer, I want you guys to know that a lot of these plugins are featured on Ascripts, but Ascripts in no way sponsored this video. But if you guys want to check out any of these plugins, there are going to be links down in the description. Some of them are going to be affiliate links to where we will make like a little kickback for any time you guys buy them, and that will help out the channel a huge amount. So thank you guys as well. At the same time, don't get any plugins that you guys are not going to use, because I don't want you guys getting stuff that's not going to be useful. So definitely consider all the plugins on this list. See if this is going to save you time. See if this is going to be something that's going to be a complete game changer for you, as it has for me. And hopefully, if you guys make something really cool, I want you guys to send it to us on Instagram. But most of all, make sure that you guys smash that like button if you guys sat around for the end of the video, because, you know, wouldn't have been possible if it wasn't thanks to all you guys liking and saying hey that you loved all these plugins. Also, while you're at it, make sure that you subscribe and ding that post notification bell so you don't miss out on any of the super dope stuff that we got planned. Yo, you guys, we're almost at 200,000 subscribers. That is freaking mind-blowing. I honestly did not know that this would happen right now. Like, well, actually I kind of did, but I'm not gonna gloat. So anyways, a big heartfelt thanks to each and every 200,000 of you all. Yeah, hope you guys have a dope Halloween if you're watching this before Halloween. And hey, if you guys are sticking around until the end of the year, have a happy holidays, but we probably are gonna have doper videos out by then, so make sure you guys check those out as well. Follow us on Instagram, at BLACKMIXTURE, to see more behind the scenes, interact with us, you know, while we're on the go and doing little things about our day. Anyways, thanks for watching. Hope to catch you in the next one. Peace.
Go, what's up? Yeah, you know where it's at.